today, but they didn't give me time to tell you the response. Maybe next session. Your Honor, I wish that you allow me to say some words, and I wish that the prosecutor will not interrupt me until I finish my word. And I don't mind to repeat the demand he or the procedures he wants to take against the witness. Let me just complete, Your Honor, and he can take whatever measurement he wants. First, I think, I am sure that that witness in particular wasn't going out of the scope of the case. All his talks about the jail. You saw him, Your Honor, and when he saw, and you asked him, do you ask the defendant, do you accept this witness for you? He said yes. And this is a good thing. We appreciate it. And this witness talked about his testimony about the president. And he said that the prosecutor or anyone else make some arrangement with him in advance to say something else. So when he said that he saw someone look familiar or whatever, you should check that. If Your Honor, you threaten him by interrogation and detain, and this is not acceptable. No, I'm talking about the prosecutor. He said he asked a particular thing. Judge, he didn't mean that in particular. Another thing, Your Honor, for your information, I want to ask a question. Does it possible for a prosecutor to be there during the interrogation of a witness in the case he's a prosecutor in? The prosecutor, he was attending the interrogation during they are interrogate Awad al-Bandar and in the presence of his lawyer. In the same case we are dealing with now. Is that possible? This is an example. Another example, Mr. Prosecutor, in the first day, when there was a request from Sa'adun Shakir to come here to be a witness, he refused. He went to him in the next day, and he was carrying the three Bassas report, and he said, only come there to the court and say that these reports you have been received from so-and-so. But he said, I didn't see these reports, and he threw it away. And he punished him, and he bring him here, and he said that he wants to turn him to a defendant. And you said last time that you will check how the prosecutor go to a witness to the camp, and Sa'adun Shakir is there, you can ask him. You in particular can see him and see how the prosecutor gave him this report and asked him to do so. And the other guy says that I don't know this. Sa'adun Shakir says I don't know this report and throw it away. And he came here and he gave you a written memo to turn this man from a witness to a defendant. So we want you to know that these witnesses are under pressure. We are not God. We should check. And me, for example, the Americans accused me that there is $4 billion missing from Iraqi safe. I wasn't afraid, and they arrest me until they make investigations, and then they come to the conclusion that I am a very honest man and didn't do it. So maybe that disc issue is just like that. Maybe if we check it, we will discover that he is wrong, and when our defense time comes, we will tell you something, and maybe you will be convinced about our point of view at that time. That's what I want to say about the two events took place here. Prosecutor, is there a need for you? Yes, Mr. Prosecutor, want to clarify something? The first point mentioned by Taher Hashi Ramadan concerning that the prosecutor has the right to attend the investigation, I already said in this matter, and I mentioned that I am the chief prosecutor outside the court. Here I am a prosecutor, but outside this room, I am the chief prosecutor in the Iraqi High Tribunal. This is my duty, and from my duties is to check in anything, in an evidence, or in testimony, or in case. Before this court began his first session, I went and I took the names of the witnesses and their testimony, and I met the witnesses and few defendants. So I can make a clear picture about the situation and about what they said and their testimonies in front of the investigation judge. This is one. The other point you mentioned, that Saadun Shaker, yes, I did meet Saadun Shaker before he came here as a witness to the courtroom, and the court didn't, before the court allowed him to come in 3 or 4 days. And there is a bunch of witnesses I saw, and all this has been recorded. But if you said that Saadun Shaker told you that I forced Saadun Shaker to witness, to give his testimony about the report, so this, I would say this is not true, and this is the CD for the record for 10 minutes about my meeting with Saadun Shaker, and it proved that what you said is not right, is not true. And if the court allow this CD to be shown, we can prove at that time that what the defendant said is not right. And what he said, that the prosecutor is forcing the witness something he don't wish to say. And that will prove how we appreciate every witness come here, and I could give him my hand and be honest with him. And this has been recorded. And everywhere I go, the event I took place there, it has been recorded. Judge, when the court has the time, we will listen to that CD. Not now. We don't have much time. That was a direct meeting between him and Saadun Shaker, not on this CD. Judge, okay, we will not talk about this issue now. Thank you, Your Honor. Defendant Barzan. Your Honor, presiding judge. Allow me to talk in few things that in my opinion is very important and basic for our situation here in this room. Your Honor, Imam Ali says that unjustified situation is weakening the nation more than retreating. So the nation which their parties are in a conflict is much power than the nation not. Your Honor,
هدف المحكمة.
The goal of this court
ورئيس المحكمة.
And the goal of the chief of that court
هو
in my opinion is to reach the truth.
وسعة صدر المحكمة.
And the patience of that court and the first person here is a basic element to reach the truth. And there is some basic things are very known for you. It says that if we are concerned about the law today, we should be concerned about it yesterday. And we will be tomorrow. Your Honor, I am here in this position. I said in front of you more than twice and in front of the Mr. Rizgar once that I am during the interrogation I was being manipulated to give a testimony against Saddam Hussein and I refuse it. This principle because this is not a moral principle and it's against the law of God and anything else. And nobody stopped in my face and the Mr. Prosecutor didn't stop in my way or claim any more details of me. Your Honor, not only me has been played with or demand to give a testimony against my colleagues, but there is a number, a large number of in the jail were being asked to give a testimony like this. And one of them is here, they call the comrade Awad al-Bandar. They ask him to do so. And me, in front of you, I just told you that they asked me to do so. So why, there's a question, why nobody asked us about the issue of this issue? And this is already impeaching the honesty of the Iraqi law. The witness, Your Honor, we discussed that already. In my opinion, and I am not a young person, and not a simple man. In addition, as I told you, I already study law. So the thing we heard from the witness, I didn't find anything out of the scope of what he came to say, including when he said that his words about the prosecutor. He was telling a story about the jail. And I want to ask the judge, that's not because I want to teach anyone, but it's my right to say this in front of you and in front of the court, because the law gives me that right. At the same time, I am a victim, so if something goes wrong in this court, so I am concerned about it. So whenever the witness says something about the prosecutor, he's talking about the jail. He didn't go out of that scope. So I think, and I beg you to take my speech in a good intentions, when we heard the witness say something like that, and we could take whatever important in his testimony and left and leave the other things, and we treat that witness kindly, because if we talk with him with angry, what kind of voice do you think I talk to the witness with? Did we use some kind of bad tone. I'm talking about the witness. When we listen to him completely, maybe he can tell us something important for the case.
But
when we told him that we will arrest you and we will investigate with you, maybe he had something else he will not say. And finally we will be the losers in this case. Your Honor, there is also a logic, a common logic, that anyone in position, a public position, always being, anyone could talk badly about him, especially if he was an honest man. So, in the same time, there is a public logic that there's no one is unmistakable. All of us are humans, and any human could make a mistake. And anyone is concerned about his the rightness, his conscience. So if we talk about something and the man in position didn't have the patience to listen, and if we are such a person who has no patience, we should go far from the position. Because there are some people could be sent to a victim if we take this position and we don't have the patience to do that. So if the person took the position, he should bear the other man until he completes what he wants to say. Another thing, Your Honor, I heard some things you said. It was very hard and cruel about the defense team. And now, after the situation is calmed down, and you are listening to me, and the defense team in the morning were silent, because they are very concerned about the system and the judicial and legal procedures. Because earlier in the past we didn't have any problem. And me here with you in this room, if I see you outside, I will not have anything against you, because you have information about me. Because we are very known people, and you know them. I don't have any things against anyone. I love others. You are talking about I am Kurdish and you are Arabic and whatever. Why every session you have a lecture? I am Iraqi. I am Iraqi, and I am telling you, and I am telling you all, don't mention that I am a Kurdish or Arabic or whatever. You are accused in a case, and only by coincidence I am your judge. Maybe someone else tomorrow will judge you. Why this moral speech every session? Your Honor, I am not giving a lecture. I am just clarifying things, my opinion to you. You are responsible for me, negatively or positively.
Yes,
you are talking about the defense team, and they know better than you in law. They can speak for you. I told the defense team, yes, you should not tell the witness to say something in particular. I am not a spy. Judge, by this word and this motive, you are talking to me now. God knows what you can do in the past. I want everyone to be living with dignity, but not like you. There is defendant, there is defense, there is prosecutor. Every session you have a lecture, and every time you begin with God's name, and God himself will not accept more of your word, much of your word. You are imbuing the patience of that court, of this court. And if this is a police court, you will not have the right to say all this. What do you mean by police trial, Judge? You know that very well. If this court is behind curtains, you will not say all this. Sit down. Sit down. Take a seat. Don't talk with that tone. Get him out. Get him out. Take him out now. You came here to teach us how to be moral, how to be honest. Every time you have a speech, began with by the name of God, and then you say something, God do not accept it. Now he's talking like this when he was outside. How he can behave? God bless us all. That's you begin with the name of God, and then you attack everyone. Me, sometimes feel pity about him when he said, I am sick. Every session we have the same thing. Who is the lawyer for that defendant? Only you? Anyone else? Another lawyer? Two lawyers? If your defendant continue on one, he's done. This is a final decision from this court that we will not allow him to enter this courtroom, and we will put him in a cell and give him a television and microphone in his cell. You should talk to him during the delay of this court. He should behave like a defendant, not like, I don't want to describe it anymore. You are assigned to talk to him and to make him behave. I will not accept in the next session his behavior just like that. You talk to him. Yes, Your Honor, but you allow him to speak and you should listen to him. Yes, we allow him, and he began with the name of God, and then he began to attack and to insult people and to insult the court. Is you are a man of law, is that acceptable? Did you see in your professional life such a behavior, such taking advantage of the patient of this court? And this is a very bad thing to do. Your Honor, he didn't attack anyone. What do you mean, lawyer? What do you mean he didn't attack? All he has to do is carrying a sword and use it. He wants to say that the defense has nothing to do with the witness, with telling the witness what to say, and maybe this is a critical subject. Judge, every session he has a poison word towards the court, not to me in particular, but he's insulting the justice. We are not telling the witness what to say, and we didn't do that. The witness is responsible in front of God to what he's saying. So the defendant was telling the court to clarify to the court that this wasn't happened. Judge, you are a lawyer, and you are a standing law, and you have the duty to talk to him, to talk with flexibility to the court, and to behave himself, to behave in appropriate way, and in front of this court and in front of those people who listen to this court, because the people outside will judge the defendant, how he speaks, how he behaves, if this is the behavior of a defendant inside the court, there is millions of questions addressing to the court about the behavior of the defendant. We want you, Your Honor, to face the to meet with the defendant during the break of 10 minutes you request. And there was a foreign man canceled that meeting. Your clients are detainees in the American side, so this is normal. Our word to our clients is recorded through an instrument, and this is not legal in any international law. We will continue listening to the witness, to the rest witnesses, and this side things will take our time. Every session we have this moral speech, and you can call the witness, Your Honor. One word, Your Honor. Yes. Your Honor. You always insist that we left ourselves in your responsibility, and you said always leave that to the evaluation of the court. So what the witness says today is a very dangerous thing to us when he said that I was forced to give a false testimony against the defendant. So the court should prevent such a thing. And I myself told you that they told me to give a testimony against the president and I can go home. So this thing you should investigate, and you should protect us as a defendant. You should not prevent anyone from giving his testimony, because any one of the defendants may was being played with and asked to be given a full testimony. Yes, one of you lawyers. I want the court, through the court, to return Mr. Berzan, because the witness here is testifying for him. You, as a lawyer for that defendant, and you are a very professional lawyer, if the defendant invalid the procedures of the court and insult the judge and the justice and repeat that behavior in different sessions, what your judgment will be? You will keep him. I am talking to the patient. I am asking the patient of the court. There is no other term to describe what he said unless it's ugly. It's hard me to say, but he is taking advantage, an ugly advantage, of the patient of this court. But he didn't mention it, Your Honor. He didn't mention it. No, I will not bring him again during this session. And we will listen to other defendant witnesses. We will delay his witnesses to the other session. And I hope that we take advantage of the time remain to listen to other witnesses. Yes, lawyer, we ask the court to allow me to a few minutes before this session ends after the court finished listening to the testimonies, to give me some minutes. I want to discuss something. When we are done, we will give you the chance to speak. Witness number 5. Sit down and take off your glasses so I can look at you. Sit down. Stand up, put your hand on the Holy Quran. I swear by Allah to testify with the whole truth and nothing but the truth. You know the subject of your testimony and why they bring you here. Yes, Your Honor. Peace on you. Peace on the President. In 1982, in the 8th of July, the President visited the jail, and I was standing outside the jail when the convoy of the President entered the jail. And I was shopping. It was Thursday, a Ramadan day, so the convoy entered the jail. It was slow until he reached the police station in the jail. And you know, he is a symbol for an Arabic nation, so everyone gathered to greeting him. So when he reached the police station, he climbed over the roof, and we start saluting him. And then he went to the old part of the jail, and we were still saluting him and following him until he went to the mosque. He entered the mosque, and then he entered another house, one of the tribe sheikhs, and when he get out, some farmers slain some sheep for him, and then he entered his car and then went to Baghdad. We were following him and saluting him, and we were very excited about his visit because he is very well known in our neighborhood and we love him very much. So when he reached the Ibrahimiyya neighborhood,
وصلت إلى قريب منطقة الإبراهيمية.
When he reached that area,
فتحت نار.
There was shot fired against him.
النار من كان فتح على موكب السيد الرئيس نار كثيفة.
So it was a very heavy fire.
السيد الرئيس فانسحبنا رجعنا إلى القصر.
We ran away. We
فمن صار انسحاب؟
Retreat.
رجعنا للأرض اللي راح.
Some of us went to his home. Some of us went somewhere else. My home is outside the jail, so I went home quickly. When I went home, as I heard that the president returned back to the village, to the place, and he climbed over the clinic, and they told me that, of course, I didn't see it. For me, when I went back home, when I went to the jail again, I saw some popular army guys. One of my chief came to me and said, you consider yourself in alert situation. And one of us was from the security officer of the jail. And we went to search the orchards area, and there was security with us. The security went to the houses, but us, we were the popular army, were went to the orchards. And the orchards were very crowded. When we start searching the orchards, we find army weapons and RPGs and snipers and BKCs and anti-craft weapons and so on. And we find printers and radios. We are, of course, soldiers, not officers. So we spent 3 days searching for that, and we handed these weapons to our officer, and our officer gave it back to the security team. We find very much too many weapons there, because we spent 4 days searching there, and we searched all the orchards. And near one of the palm trees, we find some radios. Yes, radios and printing papers and printers. All this we find in orchards. So we with retreat, and we spent, as I said, 4 days in that searching process.
No, I shot. No, it's not. I shot.
This is my testimony. So you were in the searching team, and you find weapons, different kind of weapons and printers. What do you mean by radios? Radio, wireless radios, Your Honor. Wireless radios. I find 9 or 8 of them. Me, myself, despite my colleagues, I find 8 or 9 of them. And we find shelters and places to hide there. Anything else? No, Your Honor. The weapons you talked about was on the roof? No, inside the orchard. What do you mean inside? Inside there was holes and shelters digged there, and we find just like the shelters built by soldiers, and there was the weapons was in it, inside it. You mean hot, like mud hot? No, holes in the ground and with shelters, and there is some piece of wood on it, and it's covered with wood. and the weapons was inside it.
Judge,
if you can, if tell me how many weapons there were, how many pieces of weapons from the grenade, Your Honor, there was about a lorry, a load of lorries, and RPGs and RPG rockets and other things. Judge, okay. The weapons you find. Okay. The weapons.
So
AK or all kind of. If you allow me, Your Honor, there was a rifle, a Kalashnikov, AK, and an RPG against person. It was a military weapon, and there was an old type of rifles like GC. Iranian, yes, Iranian. Iranian, Your Honor, two or three. Did you see Iran, made in Iran? Yes, I know it. It's made in Iran. Made in Iran. I am a military guy and I can recognize kind of these kind of weapons. I have a question to you. In the same altar the bullets came from to attack the president, you find all these weapons? No. Not only that, we have found it in different altars. You said that we find all these weapons. Can you tell me why these persons who attacked the convoy of the president didn't use all these kind of weapons you talked about, all these heavy weapons? I find it next day, I don't know. It was a very heavy fire and different kind of weapons, but and they start from the left side of the orchard. How many cars were being hit by the attack? I didn't see by my eyes. But the weapons, I saw it by my eyes, the RPGs, the printers, the printed papers, everything. Yes, these printed papers against the government, I meant. It was from Iran, I know it. Did you see it made in Iran? If you allow me, for me, the man who beside me read it and said it's made in Iran. But the GC is Iranian, I know it, I sell it. 3/4 of the weapons we find, it's made in Iran. You have anything else to add? No, Your Honor. Anyone have a question? Defense attorneys, anyone have a question? Witness, answer the questions of the lawyers as far as you can understand. Understand it and then reply to it. How much time spent the witness spent in the jail until he left? How many days you were there? As a searching, you mean? If you allow me, Your Honor. After the left of the president, I went to my home. But when I came afternoon, I saw my boss and said, we are in duty. Any orders given to you to attack the jail? No, we didn't attack. We had orders to search. For us and for security, the jail security and the popular army and the battle, we have orders to search. Maybe we are 45 or 50 persons. You as a popular army, did you have orders to arrest people? Witness, no, this is not our duty. Or to torture some people? No, we don't have any such orders. Second lawyer. By the name of Allah, I want to ask the witness through the court. If through the TV, among those documents, we saw some lists about people. They said that they were teenagers. I asked the witness, because he's a Djelian, does these IDs for persons has been shown on TV for teenagers? Judge, explain to him that you mean the court issue. Those people who were transferred to the court, so the question could be clear to him. Witness, I don't know nothing about this thing. Your Honor, I mean the names were being shown by the prosecutor for the Djelian. Witness, I didn't show these IDs, all names. For me, I said that I don't have any reply for that. One of the witnesses that those names shown in the internet, there is some people of them still alive, and they wasn't accused in the jail. You are Djelian. Tell us some names for some people who not been accused in the jail case. First, he don't know nothing about internet. Your Honor, the previous another witness says I saw it on internet. I have no response. Witness, those things you find belong to whom party? A Da'wa party. Who supports that party? Witness, Iran. It was being supported by Iran. Another lawyer, defense lawyer. You were a member in this searching team in the orchards, and you said you find weapons and grenades and Iranian weapons and another military thing. As you know, was this organized by outside party? Yes, it was being organized by Iran. If you were from that area, did you see the military or the popular army or the security team attacking in a very organized attack against the people, or did you hear the president give such an order? No, the president didn't give such an order. For us, we have an order to search the orchards of the jail, and the security teams were searching the houses, as the sheriff says. And I said that the searching for houses were done by the security team, and our duties were to search the orchards. I don't know anything about the orders of the president, if he ordered such a thing you're talking about or not. Have you been compensated? Yes, everyone has been compensated. After the event, was the jail was being improved for streets and other things? Yes, there was one street coming to the jail, and now we have hospital and big streets and schools. It was a very good thing, and the city exceeded 4 times. Yes, another defense lawyer. Thank you, Your Honor. I want to ask the witness. The witness says in his words that he was a member in the popular army. And he was in the popular army in his area, in the jail area. For me, I was in popular army in the frontiers, and Mr. Taher Fi Ramadan salute us to the borders and to the frontiers and give us. You said that Taha Sir Ramadan was in the jail during you were there. Mr. Taha Sir Ramadan, if he visited the jail or not, I don't know. He didn't visit the jail? No. I don't think that he visited the jail. Let your words be more specific. When you were searching the orchards, did you see Taha Sir Ramadan? No, I told you I didn't see Taha Sir Ramadan. Do you know him? Yes, I know him. He was responsible for the Popular Army. I remember him. He saluted us too many times when we were out to the frontier. Were any other popular army than you in the jail? No. There wasn't a force in the jail. There were some people like us who were searching the orchard. Did you make any other assignment inside the city? No, that was the duty of the security. The general security, internal security, and they came the next day and they start searching the houses and the city. So when we catch the weapons, we consider it like a treasure because that's something good to find. Among this force you were in, from where you get the orders? For me, I have a superior, and they give me orders. Thank you, Your Honor. I want to ask you a question, Judge. Those bullets were being shot. It's not a bullet, Your Honor. It was a heavy fire. Okay. Against the president. Okay, Judge. From where that bullet come from? From the right side orchards. When the Ibrahimi school finish, you can find a mud wall. And I am a farmer, I know these things. About 140 meters after the school, the Ibrahimi school, you can find this wall. Can you tell us the distance between the wall and the street? About 10 meters or 15 meters? It is a very narrow street, Your Honor. Your Honor, please allow me one more question. Please. One question. The judge, okay. From what he said that the Taha Sir Ramadan was supervising of the Popular Army. So let me ask the witness, was a duty for a Popular Army to demolish the orchard? No. What is particularly the Popular Army duties? I told you, I didn't speak about the Popular Army in general, I talk about my unit of Popular Army. And we are a small battalion. We are about 10 persons, and with the commander we are 11, so we are just a small unit including in the jail, including the force in the jail, and I have the commander, but I cannot say his name. But my commander says that we have a duty. And you are in a large, your duty is to search the orchards. And for Taha Sir Ramadan, I didn't see him in the jail at all. Only searching. We are not talking about the, in general, about the Popular Army. I don't know their duties. Another defense lawyer. I want to ask the witness through the court, did he see or knew that the Berzanti Treaty was in the jail when the authors was searching? Yes, I heard, but I didn't see. First day, it was a Thursday, he came and he spent, as the others told me, the other party members. I heard it, but I didn't see it. He came to the jail and he stayed in the jail and he released some people inside the PAS headquarters. I heard that, but I didn't see him. Does the Mukhabarat involve in demolishing the orchards? No. We, as a popular army and the security. Any of the defendants want to discuss something with the witness? Defendant Saddam, it's not a question, it's something to clarify. We were fighting Iran and we have their weapons and they have ours. So all these weapons he saw, it wasn't a weapon sent by Iran, but it's a weapon, Iranian weapon. They took it from the frontier for their own purposes and brought them here. That if he had information about what I'm talking about. You have information about this? Yes, yes. With us. About the weapon, it was Iranian, yes. Coming from Iran. It wasn't one or two rifles. It was a heavy weapon like RPGs and PKCs. Only the GCs may be old, but the rest of them were heavy. We spent 4 days searching in the jail orchards. Judge, you said in the day of event you wasn't, or you wasn't in duty. Why? Your Honor, if you allow me, yes, when the fire starts, I had a nephew who is a child, 1 year and a half. So I took him and go back to home because there was a heavy fire from the orchard. And when the protection force started to reply to the fire, I took my nephew and ran through the city to my home. So they came to my home and said officially that you are in a duty. So next day morning, you should join your force. When I reached my unit, they said I had to go and search the orchard. Mr. Prosecutor, you have anything to discuss with the witness? Answer the questions of the of Mr. Prosecutor. July 1982, how old were you? 18 years old. Complete? Yes. And a little bit older, but we have a habit to write down little age than we are. You were in popular army, yes. After the period of the popular army finished. You mean the searching? No. Prosecutor, I mean after your service in the popular army finished. We were in the popular army in the headquarters itself to protect the headquarters. Okay, how many months did you spend in service? The popular army goes to the frontier, he will spend three to six months. Sometimes three, sometimes 6 months. That's depending on the order. Which class did you finish? Middle school. Did you finish it? Yes. You left it after that? Yes. Do you know that the country was in war situation? Yes. And you were much more than 18 years old. Why you were not a soldier? I went to the popular army to avoid going to the military. So you went to the popular army for that reason? Yes. Yes, because anyone joined the popular army, it could be count as an army for him, army period. If you allow me, a prosecutor, those who wish to go to the popular army in the frontier, he spent 6 months. But I spent there until my service complete, my colleagues complete their army period, and then I thrown out. When they threw me out from the party, I was being trialed and convicted, and then I get out from army. How many years you've been convicted with? If you allow me, tell us just, there is too many people who have been convicted from the jailing. I was sentenced with death. On what? I will not tell you. I cannot say about what. Okay, what about that? The sentence was being reduced by the president. When you were being released, I was being convicted. If I told you, I should, I may remove the curtain, it's better. Write it down then. Let me tell you. And you've been released in? When? I was being released after it has been reduced from execution to internal life in prison. In what date? Witness, prosecutor, in what date you left the prison? You released. Witness. When everyone has been released, when the president order of our release, we have been released. You don't know the date? The witness, no. Judge, he don't want to mention the date because he thinks that he will be known if he does. Prosecutor. You said you were being sentenced to death, and then that sentence was reduced to internal life. Yes. You serve in army? No. You have been, you wasn't being transferred to regular army. When I get out of prison, I have 4 months left in the army, so they added the years of prison to my service. Yes, I just served for 4 months and then I complete the reserve. Yes, an army man, and you serve the popular army and know different kinds of weapons. And this session you said that with your hand you find the, and load the weapons, you find the orchard. Yes, yes, with my hand. You saw mortars or heavy weapons or RPGs, rockets. Yes, yes, I saw all this. I want to ask you a question. You, when you're sitting in your home, and you are living in a farm area, and you know very well what I'm going to talk about. You sit in your home, and beside you, a stick and a knife and a rifle.